there's a great opportunity for you. And you have low opportunities. Any questions?
How is Mr. Anderson doing and where is he now?
Well, why don't you ask him yourself?
How y'all doing today? First of all, my name is Dwight Anderson. I had to get clean, and I had to stay clean in order for this documentary to touch what we're supposed to touch. And today I've got 7 years clean. This is my documentary, but when I finally came back to the world, because I was lost. But again, I said God brought me back, and I really mean that. He brought me back. The hurt that I put on my family. See, when I was out there in the world and I was using and everything, I had no feelings. You know, I was numb to reality. But God also helped me there too. He allowed me to, by showing myself, for me to relive this place where I hurt my family. You know, I didn't think that I was hurting him. Sure, I was hurting him more than I ever have wanted. And you need to understand that. Whatever your choices you do, trust me, if you do it positive, you know, your family's going to be so, it's going to bless them more than you know. But when you're doing something, you're hurting them, and you don't think you are, sure you are. Yeah, sure you are. When I was using, I had no purpose. And I'm saying that to say to young people, y'all have a purpose. You got people that really, really, really believe in your talents. And in this case, you guys are all, you know, y'all achieving it. I didn't have a purpose. That disease, it took. It robbed me of all that. But like I said again, little be known to my disease, God had another plan for me.
Amen.
Amen.
Let me say this, that you went on.
Yes, sir.
And they said, it's just recreation. I tried my best to say, no, it ain't really recreation.
No.
You're probably going to have it for a long time if you think it's recreation. But so many of them think it's recreation and I can handle this. Huh. But your story will let them know that that's just not true. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, bro. Simply for me to share this, because like I said, if you don't have a spirit, you don't have a soul. And in this case, this romance, it reassures me every time I see it. And like I said, I got knowledge and wisdom, just like the next person in here. And like I said, you all have a testimony. But it so happened that this time, God is having me come here to share mine with you guys. I went out west to USC. And in Los Angeles, California, it's wide open. I mean, wide open. And if this wasn't this kind of setting, I would get a little more raw with the conversation, but I'm going to leave it just like that. The thing that I know that made them understand that I'm on the right path is by me going around and sharing my story. And that is probably what's more important to me than my basketball ever was. Is getting out here looking at these brothers and sisters of mine. And I call white people my white brothers and sisters too, because I have, yeah. So I ain't gonna discriminate, no way, no how. Yeah. But